right, so before we start, you guys are going to be really excited about this because we have, oh yeah, whoa, big fan. You keep your fans in the corner?
Yeah, I do actually. I brought them all the way from LA.
All right, so we didn't think about a drinking game beforehand, but we thought we might open this up to the audience. What do you guys think we could do for a drinking game? Like we play quarters or a certain
word? Now mind you, I never have done like the traditional drinking games of college. So it's gonna be new to me.
Who's got a flip cup?
Oh yeah,
I've done Taken once, where like
he's
Taken two. Like every time that he like hits somebody or does something violent.
Anna suggested every time you say
never,
awesome.
Never.
Every time I say
take a shot of whiskey, then every time you take a shot of whiskey, you take a shot of whiskey.
Never, never.
Oh God.
You think you could polish off this bottle?
No.
Not me neither. Don't even try that.
Jeez.
Awesome. So that's what it'll be when we take awesome.
Whew. It's smooth, yeah. Though. Wow.
But when do we do that? Okay. So just, let's get you intro'd here before we run out of time and don't even get like a word in.
This is just apple juice, by the way.
Yeah, it's not. She's drinking whiskey through a straw if you guys want to know how weird. If you guys really want to know how weird she is off camera. So our next guest is an actress turned journalist turned entrepreneur. You were an actor in Mad Men, which is a very popular 50s kind of cool show. And then.
Whiskey is appropriate.
Oh, very cool. Yes. Did your character? So anyways, I don't know all that stuff. But then you went on CNBC and you learned a lot of skills there. You were working behind the scenes and on the camera in some cases.
Yes.
So you learned a lot of journalism behind the scenes work at CNBC. And then you went on to become a very great entrepreneur. And you are now the editor in chief of Millennial Magazine. And I think we all should give Britt Hysen a huge round of applause. Thank you so much for coming out. Okay. So, give me a tiger.
Okay.
That was not planned. Like
give
it
a tiger.
Seemed like it was. Okay. So like, how come for you? You were just an overnight success, and you didn't have to put any work into anything.
Never an overnight success. It's always the 10-year journey, and in my case, especially within journalism, it's been a 4-year journey. Millennial Magazine really was the brainchild of something that I started when I was 21. So in 2010, I went to a conference and David Zaslav from Discovery Channel had said, if you're not on YouTube, you're an idiot. And you know, as an actor at that point, it was something that was not the preferred method of acting, right? You didn't want to go on YouTube. It was kind of rinky at that time, especially with web series. But coming from the president of Discovery Channel, I said...
So this guy's credible?
Yeah, okay, right. A little bit. I said, absolutely, I have to do something like that. So I thought I was going to go... Yeah, but I thought I was going to go behind the camera, and instead I was handed a microphone and I interviewed 25 of the top Burning Man artists.
Ooh.
At this rave called Lucent L'Amour. And it basically kick-started my career as a journalist, and it was a natural fit for me. So
the rave kick-started your
career? It really did, okay. Yeah. You know, to be honest, I had no idea it was a rave. I just thought I was doing some publicity for the company I was working with, which was the Do Lab.
So you had no idea?
Yeah, I had no idea it was a rave.
And what'd you think the pill was for?
You know, headache.
Just kidding.
No, but that really did kickstart my career as a journalist, and it was a natural fit. And from there, I was hired to do a bunch of different videos for a lot of people. And then I got into politics, and then I got into CNBC as a financial. I was actually an editorial assistant,
yeah.
And I learned so much about the young entrepreneurs of our generation and how incredible they are and how incredible we are. I mean, as a generation, every stereotype that's out there is false. It's totally delusional. We are doing incredible things with our lives. We're changing the world to meet our standards.
Right.
And that's what Millennial Magazine was all about. In the process, I was doing a blog that was, it turned international. We had somebody from Nigeria that was talking about finding your own inner happiness, and somebody from Singapore that was talking about workplace bullying. And I saw that there was this underlying thread of solution-based news that they were providing me. So from there, I realized that I had something so viable in a magazine that really pinpointed who the millennial was.
Gotcha.
And that's what we're
doing.
And you
say solution-based news because they come up with an actual solution to a problem that can be replicated,
yeah,
and then by
absolutely
sharing it in a media way, then everybody else
exactly
gets a real benefit.
And as a journalist, like coming from traditional outlets, especially with CNBC, and now that was financial, but within politics.
You said it was political. Oh, yeah, politics?
Yeah, within politics, you know, it it was always about reporting the issue and never really reporting the solution. And actually, at the time, it was 2011, Occupy was happening. And I went down to Occupy LA, and I met some of the most incredible people. It was the first week, it was super clean, it was a weekend, and all these professionals came down and really shared their opinions. And I realized that it was more about occupying your heart than it was about occupying your city. And a lot of people didn't really catch on to that.
I was going to make a joke, but I like that comment.
Yeah, hashtag that. Yeah. Occupy your heart. Because that's what it is.
Did they make a difference? Like, did the bad guys get screwed?
No, no. I mean, Occupy didn't do anything, and that was the unfortunate part.
No, no, not awesome.
It was not awesome, but we said it.
But not awesome still has it.
We said it. I got to sip this.
Okay, so is Democrats or Republicans better?
Libertarian.
Oh, my. You zigged when I zagged. Okay.
Zwagged.
Okay, so it was an overnight success. You put a lot of work into it, is what I'm hearing.
Yes, absolutely. So it was really this transcendence of adaptation. You know, when I was working on one thing, it kind of turned into the next thing, and you could look at it as failures, that I've had all these different type of entities as, you know, quote unquote companies. I never actually declared a DBA until Millennial Magazine. So that is my official company, I'd have to say, from the start. But there were these series of adaptation that if you found yourself at this dead end, it wasn't a failure. It was, okay, that didn't work. Let's move on to the next thing. And I had all these ideas. It was kind of like my head exploded with ideas. And then I had to kind of sink back into one idea and use that as my arrow to kind of take me to where I am
now. That's actually, like, so when we were chatting, that is the thing that stuck with me too, is let's back up a second. You said it's important that people learn a lot of skills, right? You think it's important to kind of jack of all trades so they can kind of put things together. But then on the other notion, you say, like, zoom in on one thing and let it kind of evolve or
yeah.
So just, I mean, put those juxtaposed.
Yes,
like,
okay, so I would
especially
say that,
and abstract it for like an entrepreneur that's dealing with like a sub.
So I didn't train as a journalist. I never went to school as a journalist. You know, I didn't study journalism. It was something that I naturally fell into, but that was a skill. Hey, awesome.
Just tasting, getting it ready, getting my tongue ready for
the
attack.
Hey, I got a straw, so.
Okay. Risky trish.
But it was a skill that I learned, and it really fit me. But over time, within the 4 years, I've learned so many skills than I have in my entire life in this short amount of time. And I really have to say that as an entrepreneur, when you wear every hat, you have to be proficient in everything that you're doing. You don't have to be the best, because that's what you hire for, but you have to be proficient in it. And you learn so much in the process.
Oh, that's interesting.
But, you know, am I a graphic designer? No, but I do graphic design. I'm a journalist, first and foremost. That is my arrow, and that is the direction of this magazine. It's editorial. So everything's going to kind of fall in line. So whether you're a musician and you learn, you know, your post-production, your mastering, but first and foremost, you're a musician, so that's what your arrow is. It's anything. It doesn't matter what it is. You should really learn a ton of skills because you never know where life's going to take you, and you're never going to know when you're going to have to learn another skill. And in my case, journalism started as, first it was the story, then it was the questions, obviously the writing of it, then my editor dropped out and I had to learn how to edit.
Gotcha.
And then it was, oh, you have to build a social platform. Okay, I have to learn HTML and I have to kind of figure out this world of tech.
Right, right.
And everything kind of fell in line
So tell me a little bit more about like how you know kind of when to evolve this thing. So I definitely believe that like you shouldn't be kind of all over the place if you zoom in on something. But as a founder of a startup that did fail, I don't think we iterated enough, we didn't pivot enough. Like could you walk me through, like I know, if I remember you started with Discover Your Voice, could you walk me through like your story and maybe like touch on what were the triggers when you knew you had to switch? Like, how do you get so rapid iterations?
It's interesting. Okay, so I started with Behind the Scene with Britt Hysen, and that was a little web series about...
You want to do another shot, too?
Yeah,
it's
okay.
Kind of a long story.
All
I just
right.
Sounds like a long one.
Sorry, guys.
I mean, good. I'm excited, but this will help.
So it started with that, and then I realized that it was... Everything that I was doing was showcasing millennials doing what they loved. And that kind of turned into, wow, they were discovering their voice within this. And I wanted to pitch a show to a friend of mine who is in development at FX. And I coined it Discover Your Voice. And that's kind of where I created this web series about people really discovering their voice in whatever capacity that they were working. And a friend of mine in FX had said, you know what, they're not watching TV, they're online, so you have to build a social platform. Here I am as an actor turned journalist, kind of this new paradigm for myself, and I got a freaking code, are you kidding me? So I
but
ended
you
up.
Jumped at it.
I did.
For you.
And it wasn't that I necessarily coded, but I found a platform that enabled me to do what I needed to do at the time. And that in itself taught me about web design, and it taught me about editorial online, like digital magazines, and that just kind of transformed. Everything was the moving motion of adaptation.
And okay, so and when this person was like, hey, this is how I see the world changing, and then you were able to change, how much of your time, like if you could break down the percentages, are you out there looking for people who to give you new knowledge to help you pivot, and then how much of it are you like learning a new skill for it? Like
to
how
be
do you
honest,
break down?
I'm going through it myself, and I'm kind of navigating these waters unknowingly. You know, I'm swimming in dark water. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know what's happening.
Ooh, good metaphor. Ooh.
It's we're kind of like in the deep sea.
A tank, like we're underwater,
yeah,
and
but
it's
then
all
like
black.
All of a sudden, like a light's gonna come out. You're gonna find that
like
fish.
An electric eel,
and it's gonna swim, and it's gonna take you to where you need to go. And that becomes your guide.
Yeah, and it's like way better in water than you. Oh,
But the great thing is that along the way you find support systems, and you bring people on that really support your ideas and help
fishermen.
You grow.
And fishermen, they help you.
I don't know.
You
they're kind of
the
more
eels.
Like your school of fish.
Okay.
And they're just kind of following along with you, being like, hey, we're gonna go wherever you go.
Oh.
And you're like, oh my God, I like, do you really know where I'm gonna go? And
got the best school of fish fact for another episode. Oh shoot, we're getting close to ten minutes.
Right. All right. Into like Nemo.
Okay. But okay, I won't share it. It's an interesting fact. Well, you know, all fish in the schools, they try to get to the middle, so that's why it does that. They all constantly try to get to the middle because they're all scared when they get to the edge.
Okay.
Okay, keep going though.
Anyway, that school of fish followed me to Millennial Magazine, and now we are really positioning ourselves as Life Magazine, and we're going out and chronicling the individuals in our generation who are really making this world a better place, that are not
that's
only
awesome.
Standing up for the causes that they believe in, but they're also the CEOs that are revolutionizing business. They're the celebrities that are involved in good work. They're the everyday people who are doing something with their life. You know, that's what we're showing. We are really going into the everyday person.
It's awesome. Okay. Yeah. Well, hope, is that like, it's like
was
the late time to cue it up music.
What?
Trying to get off. Anyways.
We haven't drank enough.
But hopefully you will find many of those people in our community. I think there are many you
there
will find.
I mean, you
and
would
you guys
be
can check
example.
It out.
We would come and
no, no, no. I
you.
Lost money. I lost like a lot of money for somebody.
Hey,
important.
It's not called a failure. It's called we're going to adapt now.
So check out millennialmagazine.com or on Twitter at millennialmagz, M-A-G-Z. Thank you very much. I appreciate
you. Thank you very much.
Give a round of applause. Awesome. Thank you.